Call the meeting order. Roll call.
Mayor Westergaard.
Yep.
Schrader. Here. Olenor.
Here.
Lane's here.
Us.
Here.
Stankin.
Here.
Public forum. Okay, consent agenda. Any additions or corrections?
No.
Is there a motion to approve?
Awesome.
Second?
I'll second it.
Roll call.
Us.
Yes.
Stankin.
Yes.
Schrader.
Yes.
Vogel North.
Yes.
Laney.
Yes.
Okay, resolution 1112. Everybody's read the opinion. As to what we can and cannot do. It looks to me like we have no choice but a motion to deny the request.
I will so move.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call.
Laney.
Yes.
Us?
Yes.
Stankin.
Yes.
Schrader?
Yes.
Vogel North?
Yes.
That's it.
It's done. Thank you.
Thank you. I'd like to thank everybody for the participation of the process. And besides, everybody can sign up for carnival duty later on.
Is that why it's right to stop signing?
That's good. Right here. You already signed it up. Everybody be working an hour. Okay.
Duplex.
Yeah.
Just mentioned a duplex.
Four. Just gonna get one. Yeah, because he can do that without anything. Okay, community club for the circus.
For the circus. Did you get the chance to take a look at those links that I emailed out to you? Kind of describing the circus. But,
just provided some credibility, I think, if nothing else. I mean, people had posted on the Facebook site, had posted that they had great, you know, experience. They posted pictures. I mean, that to me is worth far more than just a brochure or web page. I mean, that was people that actually had attended and expressed a good experience. So.
I believe it could cost us something.
Doesn't cost us anything, although Jim Stock did stop in today. He said, we get a lot of truck traffic in back there, he says, and we're getting some potholes back there. You know, can you fill the potholes to make it a suitable place for the circus to come?
Is it like 10 of them, 100 of them?
Yeah, like just a couple. It's
wouldn't be much
a couple effort.
They can put some dirt and take the grader, like the dough.
It may be a couple truckloads of rock or whatever.
Hopefully the elephant
doesn't.
Maybe
he
can do it.
Yeah. The elephant can drag a drag down there.
There you go.
What time would this be?
It's an evening show. One evening show. 7 o'clock.
Is the name they go by this?
They refer to themselves as either Family Fun Circus or they refer to themselves as Big Top Circus.
Big Top. Because they're doing it in Breda.
Okay.
I saw a sign for it today that they're doing it in Breda. So.
And it must be right the day before.
Yeah.
Because I asked him if the date was subject to change. No, he was really kind of married to that date. Adults cost $12. Adults cost $12 to attend, but the kids get to attend for free.
That's marketing.
Yeah.
Just
have John take care of Ryan.
I'll take care of Ryan.
I'll take him.
Oh, but I could teach him
front
so
row.
Much.
Maybe shoot me all the way up.
Oh, we'd have fun, though.
Please. Always trying to be helpful.
I know. Helpful.
Yeah.
Just like the giving tree.
Yeah.
So do we have a motion to allow them to use the city-owned land?
I'll make that motion.
Second?
I can do that.
Roll call.
Vogel North.
Yes.
Laney.
Yes.
Us?
Yes.
Stankin.
Yes.
Schrader?
Yes.
Okay, we need to approve the liquor license for the Redemption Center.
I missed one.
Oh, I missed the closure. I'm sorry. I'm ahead of myself. Most of the clothes for the carnival. We're going to do anything different than we've always done?
Pretty much a lot of the same events that it has been in the past. It's on page 7. Is the is the flyer. Still a draft flyer because we don't have our corporate sponsors really nailed down, just down to the nitty gritty. But we have plans to do a bicycle BMX show, which would be, you know, jumping ramps, this type of stuff. And we had things lined up with this BMX club from Des Moines to come do that. But I tell you what, we have not heard back from them for a long time, and I cannot even get a hold of them. So I'm not real optimistic that that's going to happen. If it does happen, we would propose to have this show on 3rd Street there by Lori Quinn's Denny Cooley's, that block. It would take, we just block the whole, that whole block for the Saturday afternoon and evening, early evening. Other than that, everything's pretty much the same. Parade route is proposed to go down to 1st Street. It adds two more blocks to the length of the parade route that way.
We'll need more Tootsie Rolls.
Two more blocks worth of Tootsie Rolls, Mayor.
Have another bathtub full of water.
Yeah.
No water,
you probably
get
tissues. He could reload them, yeah. You have to reload for the water. So we need a motion for the street closures and the water carnival.
I need to do that. I'll second.
Okay, roll call.
Thank you.
Yes.
Schrader.
Yes.
Coleman North.
Yes.
Laney.
Yes.
Huss.
Yes.
Now we'll do your liquor license.
We hope.
We'll need a motion to approve that.
I'll make it.
Second?
I'll second.
Roll call.
Schrader?
Yes.
Huss?
Yes.
Thank you?
Yes.
Oval North?
Yes.
And me?
Abstain.
Well, that's the first time that's ever happened, isn't it?
No.
Oh, hasn't it?
No. Before that, this last, we did this last year, too.
Oh, yeah. You just voted present last time, wasn't it?
I'm going to tell him.
Rise Grant. This will be good.
Yeah, So we were awarded that RISE grant for $149,313. What's that?
I think you should read through the whole thing tonight.
Okay. Mine's marked with yellow. Is any of yours marked with yellow?
Eight.
Yeah. We got this thing on Friday.
And they threw it in my front porch. It went whoop.
Right through the window.
It went what?
It went whoop. Sound like three phone books.
Okay, all
right. Well, I got this thing on Friday when I wasn't here. So I left instructions with Kay that if we got it, you're supposed to include it in there. So she included everything. Including a lot of that stuff on the targeted small businesses and stuff. That's just kind of a contract add-on. I mean, it's something we have to do, but it's just the way that we did. Put out notice to those folks. Anyway, I'm on page 8. Just to go through and kind of hit some of the highlights of this. That the RISE grant, the program, is governed under Iowa Code Chapter 315 and also some administrative rules of the DOT. And those do define what acceptable uses are then for the property. And it includes, of course, the industrial and warehousing and wholesaling, and corporate business offices, but both of those still also include tourism, whether the DOT commission chooses to, you know, implement that or not, but still, in statute, it still refers to tourism. Bottom of the page in number 3, this just describes our project, but here's what we are responsible for: the development and completion of the following project, which is the right-hand turn lane on US 71 and approximately 712 foot of the extension of Boulders Drive. Top of the next page shows cost breakouts. It's just that there's a RISE grant for up to 50% of the project, okay, or a maximum of $149,313. Item 7 there, if you look back at Exhibit B, that lays out what acceptable uses are, and if you look at Exhibit E, that lays out what some of the ineligible costs are, and it's very consistent with what we had known going into this. It basically describes that the street work, the storm sewer, any of the grading work, those are all considered eligible. Additional utility work, like sanitary or water is not eligible. Sidewalks are not eligible, and those are all shown on Exhibit C. On page 10, next page, top of the page on point 11, there is an attached project implementation schedule, and that schedule was still based upon our original application, and they've asked us for a revised schedule on that, so we would need to get that schedule changed to, this new schedule would propose that we could let bids sometime around October, potentially begin construction in November, but just have a completion date on it by May 1st of next year. So some construction could potentially occur during the fall, but primarily next spring.
Scott, I'm sorry, I should have said something to you. I'd like to go back to number 10. The DOT reserves the right to delay reimburse rental funds. How often does that happen? And if there is such a delay, how long of a delay is there usually there?
I don't know that it happens, but this refers to 5 days. That if it's any more than 5 days, they need to notify us in writing.
I will say, like, when we bid jobs, you know, with like road jobs, usually the DOT doesn't bid anything or let anything unless they have the money in an account. They don't bid it and then pay for it as they go. So they're usually pretty good as far as what I've dealt with.
Mm-hmm. I just put the state cash flow on stuff like that. I don't know what the government's doing. So this is true for this.
Okay, item 17 talks about if this road crosses the DOT primary road, which it does intersect with that. So just item A, it says that we would convey title to the state by quitclaim deed, but the state, the DOT, is responsible for preparing the legal description and the plat. So that would be us transferring city right away in the intersection. I didn't have any marks on the next page. On page 12, item 23, just that the project plans and specs and the cost estimate, they need to be prepared by a certified professional engineer. Okay, and these plans are then submitted to the DOT for review. So it takes 30 days, a 30-day review period for it to go to the DOT. Okay, but the really good news is that we can let bids locally. It doesn't have to be a DOT bid letting. They need to review the plans, but we still let it locally. 25 talks about us just maintaining all of the books and everything pertaining to the cost incurred for the project, because these need to be retained for 3 years from the date of final reimbursement. So that's essentially the life cycle of the grant, is 3 years after the final reimbursement is received. Next page, page 13, starting with item 31, that the agreement may be declared to be in default by the DOT if the DOT determined that the recipient's application for funding contained inaccuracies, omissions, errors, or misrepresentation. Okay? Or if the DOT determines that the project is not developed as described in the application. Now that's where we describe how it would be developed. And we said wholesaling, warehousing, light industrial, corporate office. Now those are the items that are specifically allowed under the RISE grant. But you know, the staffer says to me, she says, you know, we're not naive to the fact that things don't always develop the way that they're supposed to. There's a lot of projects out there that have never developed. Or there's other projects out there that have commercial development within them. Okay, the big thing to note that I asked her specifically about then repayment, if it ever goes into default, do you ever require a repayment? She said, we have never required any repayment. And
I thought there was one example where there was some
out of this competitive program.
Okay.
Okay? They've never required that out of the competitive program, but out of the different program, immediate need program or something like that, where you have a business on the hook who needs road access to them. When we went to the DOT commission meeting, they had two of those projects that didn't quite meet their job creation requirements. And one of them was a couple jobs short on meeting job creation requirements, and they had to pay back, I tell you, $6,000 out of a couple $100,000 grant. But the one that was really interesting was the one to Webster County. I think it's for that ethanol plant there, west of Fort Dodge. They got a $600,000 grant to put in this road to the ethanol plant. The ethanol plant was to create 100 jobs and never did. The ethanol plant ended up creating 9 jobs, and they had to give some of the money back to the DOT. They created 9 out of 100 jobs, and they had to pay back $21,000 out of $600,000. And 33 continue to talk through the process about what would happen if there was a default. They give us 30 days notice. We'd have 30 days to respond and cure the default. But 33 says, in the event that the default is not cured, the DOT may revoke funding or seek repayment of the loan. And again, they've never required a repayment of a loan through this program, or a grant through this program.
And we can assume then that that's for a period of probably 3 years. Because obviously they can't hold us this for 50 years from now.
No, you know, because it's kind of like the industrial development up at SAC that was put in with the RISE grant, and nothing ever developed out of that. And I think it gets to the county shed, and nothing's developed out of that, but they've never had payment back.
Well, I would assume there's a limit on how long they can.
That's why I say you got to keep those records 3 years from the date of
closeout. So that's what I'm assuming that.
It ends up being, say it's 4 or 5 years from now.
Yeah, okay.
So the term of the contract will be 3 years, or 3 years from the last?
3 years from the date of last payment to us.
Based on what some other councils did here 10 years ago, well, not even the last there.
On 35, it refers to our maintenance responsibilities. We have maintenance responsibilities out there for at least 20 years. Of course, it will be platted as a city street. We will have perpetual maintenance responsibility. Bottom of the page is 40, that we notify the DOT within 30 days of the opening, okay, and then the recipient self-certify the DOT's contact person with 2 years of the date of the RISE project is constructed and open to traffic any economic development which resulted from the project. And the DOT continues to monitor progress of the associated economic development following the RISE project. That basically is the agreement there. I know there's a lot more in the packet. And a lot of that pertains, again, to this targeted small business stuff, which is just, we need to give special notice through bidding, clearing houses, that type of stuff. And that's all taken care of through this process. What I would like to do, before we would consider passage of this contract, is to get a development agreement in place with Fulton. And that's based off of that memorandum of understanding that we've had for a while now. And that's on page 28. Where this memo says that in consideration of these points that were listed, we would agree in the future to negotiate a development agreement. I want to get that development agreement negotiated before we get under contract with the state. And that will then allow us to try to address any concerns that the council would have. You know, because as we work through this process and it involves that special assessment, you know, we need to get our development agreement in place, and then there's some procedural things on the special assessment that has to happen. But you get right down to the end of the special assessment. The special assessment has to pass by a 4/5 vote of the city council. Okay? And Tony probably shouldn't vote. So I think the development of this development agreement is just extremely important, because it's at that time that we need to address any concerns that the council has. So what I would propose is that here in the next couple of weeks, I talked to George about that for quite a while this morning. He understands that we want to work towards this agreement. That over the next couple of weeks, we would try to negotiate this development agreement with them. And there are a few things that I would like to do, or a couple things, in the interim, is a good portion of this development agreement revolves around that special assessment. Okay, I need to contact our bond attorney in order to implement that special assessment properly. And the other thing that I would do here in the next couple weeks also is take proposals for engineering services, so that we know for sure exactly how much that engineering is going to end up costing. That's what I would like to do. The other thing that I think would be great is if we could have a council committee together to help formulate this development. I'm really looking for a couple of volunteers who might want to work on a development agreement.
Okay, I'll take one.
He's kicking one of the table. I'm trying to reach
him. Can't reach you.
Something like that. I'm going to go into this with the thought of that never say never. I want to make sure that the city is protected in the case there is a default. That's we're all needing to be given some input on that part of it, because, like I said, never before.
Well, I agree. I wear both hats, but I agree.
But I think from this council here, we need to get some legal advice. We need to get somebody else's advice to go on what your concerns are and how we can address it. Like I said, I think it's something that needs to be developed, but I don't want to develop it at the city's expense or in the future of have problems down the line. I want to make sure that we cover our gray areas. And that's my biggest concern. And what do you think about the city?
Well, I don't know.
Well, we got to put that up in a hurry.
I already said that.
We just want to know, in case of a default, the city's not hung out to dry.
That's not what this is.
No, but that's what the agreement.
That's what we're going to work on. That's why I don't...
The agreement should say that. Otherwise, I don't have any concerns on the fact that there is a default,
well,
and DOT wants their money back.
Won't say that. The agreement, yeah. That's
the agreement, the agreement holders say that.
Yeah, that's the city of Boulders. That's important.
Yeah.
DOT is language.
Yeah, that is, they don't care who the other party is.
But I want to make sure that we got everything cleared up to a day.
Nobody else wants to do it, I'll be the partner.
Will you?
Well, I would happily do it, but I don't think that would be appropriate, so.
Why couldn't you do that as long as you can't vote, right?
Well, I don't think that's appropriate.
Oh, your partner's sitting on the other side of the table.
Well, he might be, yeah.
Makes it a little challenging.
And I wouldn't want to do anything that wasn't politically correct.
Well, I know, that would be a stretch. I wouldn't want to make you uncomfortable.
But you'll sit in on the committee anyway.
Well, sure, I'll be there. I always want to give my nickels worth.
Very good.
I sure wish I could babysit Ryan.
So what kind of time frame are we talking that you want to get this going, proposal?
Do they have a time frame? The DOT, do they?
Yes.
Do they have a time frame? Like their offers only goes until?
Nope. Before they run out of
money. It doesn't hang out there perpetually, but if it takes a month, that certainly is.
I think the sooner the better.
If we could get things done in a couple of weeks, that'd be terrific.
Yeah, because if there's any work that obviously could happen, that would be advantageous.
Yes.
For everyone.
Like when the highway shut down, that'd be a really good time to do it.
That'd be
a aggressive.
Rush.
That's awesome.
So I met with George this morning, gave him a copy of this DOT agreement, and he was going to check with their attorney too about what type of a assurance they could offer us.
So when do you want to have this first meeting?
Well, I will get a hold of George and we'll see if we can get something set up.
I'm flexible now.
You are. No job weighing you down.
Not anymore than normal.
Okay, really, that's it. Any other?
You want to meet during the day or?
Well, with Whitey, you know, it pretty much dictates we'd meet during the day.
Anytime after 4:30, try to get back here. Yes, I guess. So the wheels fall off somewhere.
So we need to table the RISE grant thing until.
We're just not going to take any action.
Yeah, there's really no action to take on it. We just discussed the contract tonight. But if you have any specific concerns, you know, some of my concerns are just the procedural stuff out of the special assessment. I need to get those addressed. But other than that, and the, you know, how you've talked through some ideas about how you'd like to deal with Roger Peterson. We just want to treat him as a citizen who's subject to the assessment, or would you like to have a side agreement with him too? You know, there's some different issues like that we can discuss. Basically, he gets deferment on it until he develops that. Yeah.
Can't make him do anything. All I can do is make his property more valuable.
That'd be a good thing.
Okay. We'll get together and get the committee meeting put together.
Yep, we'll do.
Okay. Approve the pay estimate for Ice House Point Trail.
Yeah, this one we had actually paid at the last council meeting. This is just to formally approve the pay estimate document. And just a little discussion on this will be the sub-final pay estimate. We still owe them the retainage of $38.57, but other than that, the project is essentially done. Question about where the silt fence was and whether they got to reseed that or anything. You know, they claim they don't have to reseed. So.
Weeds will grow. We just need a motion to approve that pay estimate.
Yeah.
Second?
Okay.
Roll call.
Laney.
Yes.
Huss.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Schrader.
Yes.
Golden North.
Okay.
Just a real little bit on that. You want, since you're here, Lon, can you describe a little bit what the project's going to be for the extra bump outs and the area out at the point?
That was really good.
Yeah. Let's get the rose guard done first.
Yeah, thanks. Thanks for that.
Good down there. Did you go down? It looks nice.
The rose garden looks good. Sidewalks
look good.
Did you
go down there tonight? I went down
there tonight.
They got the brick in today. We did. They got I'm waiting on the lights to show up on that. But the dirt work down at the pump, we'll have some sprinklers up, get some grass, and hopefully more hard than we don't can. But the deal, Scott and I visited a little bit about that deal out there today. I don't know how elaborate you guys want to get. You know, if we do, you know, we talked about kind of a circle bench out there and then with the canopy on top of it. But, you know, just like visiting with Scott, you know, it's going to take a lot of time. How much time do you really want to dedicate to that? Because the boys are only here for a certain amount of time. And you got quite a few projects. You got two buildings to shingle, and then Scott and I discussed this
Third Street
project, which that's going to take some time. I mean, you're looking at some serious time there with everybody being there. So I even talked to Scott, maybe we should just do the bump outs going out to the lake first, and you know, if we had to sidetrack that project out there for a while, where Kim and them were out there that night, and Jerry, because it's going to take some time. I mean,
how long have we got to spend before we got to spend this money or get it back?
Yeah, that was my question.
We don't have to get it back. We can.
$67 million?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It ought to be spent.
Yeah.
But I mean, and our, when we get audited, our auditor will note that as unspent funds. But decide if it needs to sit there for another few months or another year.
But even if we just poured the circle for the cement and the bump outs and just left the rest later?
I was more thinking even with footings, see, that if you're going to put the posts in for a canopy, they need to be in the footing coming up through.
Right.
And then we put the benches, incorporate the benches around that. Which, you know, what Nick and I were both thinking was more like a stone bench like we did. Last forever, be there forever. But there again, it takes a lot of time.
What would the canopy be?
Well, Nick kind of had this idea of the canopy going up with the fire pit in the middle. And of course, the inside part would be open. There would be 3 to 4 benches out there in a semicircle. And just with kind of a, try to stay with a kind of your, I don't know, log cabin theme, but only really kind of out of a steel structure so somebody can't tear it apart. And the posts going up, probably put, maybe putting them wood around the steel structure. But, you know, that's, you know, time consuming and, you know.
It sounds like a neat idea. I personally like just the idea of the bench, the stone bench,
yeah.
Similar to what we have.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't know you had to kind of do it from the beginning if you're going to do the...
Well, I think we took about 2 weeks to do that, didn't it, down there?
That bench?
Yeah.
Oh, no, God, you worked on it on and off for a month, I think.
Well, yeah, but I mean, I'm talking 2 weeks of just solid people working. I've been there for 2 weeks. And there was
It takes a long time.
That's what I'm saying, you know, it's going to be a time consuming. You're going to have a lot of labor involved, not so many dollars, just dollars of labor.
But you could form up a cement one and then just use that facing like we did on those piers down here? Or?
Well,
either way, it's about the same time.
I'm looking at something that's going to be there a lifetime.
Well,
you know,
and that's what I'd like to like done.
The fascia, the stone of fascia, I don't know if it's a proven thing or not. You know, Miner Peterson's had it on his garage ever since I've worked for the city, so maybe that is a good way to do it, be a little quicker. But I'm more even with it.
The bench, the boost benches look good.
Well, I just think when you're doing it, let's make it for 5 generations, you know.
What is our schedule for what?
My schedule is right after Water Carnival, tear into that.
Which one?
Kathy's Corner.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. That's
to me, that is more important that we get that done.
Yep.
That this is.
Well, I'd like to not have it tore up for Water Carnival, but right after, they're into that. So, especially if you can work on those the bench pads,
yeah.
We can have them continue to work on the bench pads.
What's that?
Because you only got 3 weeks.
3 weeks.
So, just asking Scott if that area will be on the Rock and Run route, and it will be.
Yeah,
so, you know, it would be really nice if something,
yeah,
if it's not tore up, and if there was something, you know, out there during that time.
You know, I think it's something we could get the bench pads put in. I think we talked about 4, Scott, maybe,
yep.
Something on that order. To get them put in, I mean, that's something we can probably form up in 3 to 4 days, have that project done, that part of it. And, you know, maybe hold off on the other thing. I really, honestly, I don't think you got time to do it this year. I really don't. But, you know, if you guys want to, you got to set what you want to do first. I mean, if that's what you want us to do, we'll get her done.
I don't think it's pressing that it has.
Well, they're going to finish up in the Rose Garden, and they can work on those 4 bench pads. And that's going to shoot a lot of the time between now and Carnival, and then we'll prep for Carnival, and, pardon me?
We'll have another meeting by then.
And then it'll be time for them to start working on Kathy's Corner block. So.
But I would really like to make sure when we do something out there, it's a reason to go out there.
Mm-hmm.
Rather than we just had $6,000 we wanted to spend it.
Yeah.
If we're going to do that, we might as well just stick it on a tree and let somebody go take it.
Yeah. If we have to wait till next year, we have to wait.
Yeah. Yep.
Very good.
Okay. Now we're down to the good stuff. Engineering proposals.
Come on up, Sparky.
See if we got any good news in this.
We have weird news, if nothing else.
No, better news than this morning. In the price.
This Stanley's, if you guys remember, we're underbuilt on 2 miles of REC line over the golf course. So I've been working with these guys. And they have really streamlined their procedure. They've developed their own program. So as they're staking it, the majority of the work is done as they're staking it for bidding quantities. Everything's done by GPS. If somebody pulls a stake out, GPS coordinated so you know where to go back and stick the stake in. They use the same program that the DOT uses for GPS. You got a highlight, Scott, that you thought was highlights on?
Well, just that, as I would tell you this, we had the three of them, and basically Finley did not get strongly considered when Bill and I were working on it.
And the other ones have the price of the one.
Yeah. The other one is half the price of the one, and it makes it really simple, other than the fact that DGR's been our engineer for 40 years.
Maybe that's why they did it so high, because they just figured they'll get it in.
Now, having said that, we sent out a well-defined RFP. Both of these adequately met the requirements of the RFP. Feel very confident about that. We talked with both of the firms today. DGR's very proud of their work, and they weren't looking at the possibility of lowering their fees. You know, we discussed the fact that they're over 100% higher, and you know, they thought that it was substantiated in some regard. We talked with Stanley. Stanley just comes, you know, a very, very large, well-respected firm. Wouldn't have anything bad to say about them. Their fee was at $120,000. We talked about how we would go about the contracting with them, and just clarified again that covers every type of engineering service that we need, and it does require every type of engineering service that we included in the RFP. Now, there's one additional one we did not include in the RFP, if we would want it, is resident observation during construction time, which we may very well not want to have an inspector on site all the time. So, but they all bid them the same, so there's no observation in any of them. So you have the $284,000 one, or you got the $120,000 one, and there's no substantial reason why you would choose the more expensive one. As far as contracting with Stanley, we confirmed with their project lead that they are willing to contract at that hourly price with the not to exceed maximum as they've listed. So if you take a look at their schedule, section C, those would be the fees.
Did you say section C?
Yep.
C.
So that would be the fees. Again, we would propose a contract with them that is hourly fees, and their hourly fees are on the next page. The hourly fees with these not to exceed maximum free portion of work.
And if they were major come up, and we would negotiate that before we did anything.
In your vast experience, what would be something major that would take time?
A lot of things is deal with the public. You know, they won't let you know where you want to put your pole. Guy did. When you drop a pole and dropping a guy down, if there's enough room for a guy, you might put a steel structure in. But I don't ever see that. But just a little, you know, you never really know until you get into it. The total estimate from our FEMA was $3,100,000, the total project estimate.
So your recommendation is these guys then, right?
In a nutshell, I had to think about it a long time.
You had to think about it too long. It's much money.
Now, can you take a look at the schedule? Pull that out in section B. And this is all just their best estimate of what they would really see happening, but I really like them being a lot more aggressive with the plan preparation. This has us bidding right at the first of the year.
The reason I like that is because we want to get in on the goodie before something else happens.
Well, that gives us an opportunity to get their... When you've been that, according to my brother, that way you've got some work lined up, you know, again, something's going on, that gives you, that's a good kind of way to do it.
I even had a huge contractor out of Wisconsin email me Friday inquiring about this. I think they find out through some federal notification or something. I mean, we've already had contractors calling us before we even started the engineering. But I think that's important. The sooner we can get in there, now's the time to benefit the city.
Well, so that, what we're doing is something that's not just for a 5 or 10 year deal. It's going to be, hopefully another 15.
So do we have the leverage to make them pick up the pace? Do it quicker?
Are you talking about the engineer?
Yeah.
He's going to start right away. He's got, well, he said that could be negotiated too, John, but he's got it starting. Is it August, Scott? No.
He referred to starting this fall, you know, to get all of his data together and start this fall, get his plans together and be ready to bid by the first of the year. You know, and really about the last thing about Stanley is they have oodles of experience dealing with FEMA and feel really good about that too.
They are the most experienced.
Hate to think that we would change engineers, but by golly, I think we need to change engineers.
So that kind of mind?
Yeah.
That's kind of what we were thinking.
If they won't even talk to you about quivering, it's must be damn proud of what they got.
So, me and Scott spent at least a half a day on this today, talking to the two engineers and FEMA.
So we're down now to, it's a council decision to pick whoever they want. That's what our step tonight is.
The next step is to
pick this engineer.
Hire an engineer.
Yeah, have a motion to negotiate with Stan Allen.
I'll make it.
We'll bring a contract back to you then, but we'll just negotiate.
Is there a second on that?
I'll second it.
Roll call.
Fader.
Yeah.
Stankin.
Yeah.
Huss.
Yes.
Lena.
Yes.
Opal North.
Yes.
I ain't sure, but I think that picture on that paper is from Glid.
Guys?
Yes. From 2010, January 2010. Everybody all fell down.
Yeah.
You don't want them anymore?
Yeah, you take mine too. I'm a wood burner in this building.
Environmentally, it's friendly.
That's my biggest.
The new fiscal year then is July 1. And new wages for covered employees kick in on July 1. This would have new wages then for everybody proposed. The wages for those for the union employees include that 2% wage increase. And there's blanks for all of the non-covered employees.
I'll start.
I'll be second.
Okay. Here's what the military gave me this year on my retirement. Zero. In fact, I got a deduction. So, my proposal is zero.
That's
all I got to say.
I'm gonna change a little bit. I figure, I think we should hold the line consistent with what we have. And I see that wrong, giving about 2%.
And that's been the way it's going fast.
Now we've been fairly consistent with that over the years.
Whatever the union got, the union members got, listen.
But then the union beat us over the head with it, too. They said we gave them 2%, now you got to give the union, or we gave them whatever we
gave. 4%, so the union said, well, that's what you got to give us.
Yeah, that was larger than the union wage increase that time.
Yeah, that'd be my only concern with keeping it consistent between the two. The union really put the screws to it.
Anybody else?
They're using that as a precedent. I guess I'm not following you.
Yeah, that's what they're doing. At least that's the way I took it, that they were
saying. Last year was when the union before we gave 4%, and last year this time we gave 4% to the salary. Then
they looked at that.
They said, well, why are you offering us 2 and you just gave everybody else 4? And we said, well, that's a reflection of the previous.
Okay.
So.
Sure. I'd want to confirm this to say for sure, but there was one instance, and it seems like it was last year, where the non-union folks got more than the union, and that was. That was
that last year?
Whether it was last year or 2 years ago.
I personally think we need to be consistent with the union. I don't know how we pick one group or the other. I know there's one bit of a wage differential, but
that big either, really good.
Jerry, you're the only one who hasn't said anything.
I'm taking water now.
More years than not.
Okay. But that's my only concern, I guess.
It'll be hard to get them to and not the salary to. I mean, that's kind of a kick in the face.
Got a lot of fender.
Yeah. And the percent's not much, it's the insurance is our big issue.
I'm looking forward to the next issue.
But I'm quivering with anticipation. So does somebody want to entertain a motion for some percent or none or whatever?
I want to make it for two. I'd like to make that motion.
Okay. Okay, roll call.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Folklemore?
Yes.
Trader?
Yes.
Yes.
Me?
No.
Okay, city clerk report.
Just a couple things on what we talked about on nuisances. Talked to Pam about the back of the daydream building, about having a masonry training program come in and repair it. And contacted Job Corps, and they had a meeting about this on Friday, but I still didn't hear back from them today about whether they would be able to do this. They do projects similar to this. The concern was that it's a private building. And when they do projects, they would do a public project. So our only argument to them is that, yeah, it's a private building, yeah, but it's a public nuisance building. So we would see if they would go for that argument, but I haven't heard back from them.
Not that she did, though.
Materials that are they responsible for them?
I don't.
We have two stacks of bricks.
Yeah, there's a bunch of bricks there.
Well, we have two stacks of bricks.
Good God,
though. Oh, yeah,
oh, yeah. Oh, those bricks.
I already asked that question. Yeah, they're amazing how quick that disappears.
They'll move a lot faster than you're forcing them.
Yep. Because we moved them up here to the old ambulance building. And said, okay, Lowell, you can have 2 weeks to get rid of them, or else we're going to charge you. We're going to charge you for getting rid of them. And the Friday of the 2 week mark, they disappeared. So it worked, I guess.
Didn't you talk about putting steel on there too?
That was her plan. Because if they were going to have to do this, they would rough in the inside and put some steel. Anyway, I'd like to explore this deal with Job Corps, and if they can at all make that work, we'll try to get that.
There's got to be some structural amenities there involved.
You know, I agree with you, other than it's two walls thick. The outside wall is completely crumbled away. Right. The inside wall isn't going to match it.
I want to keep going to the top.
Yeah.
And the inside wall will pop it out and it grows.
Yeah.
Oh, and I'll have that one too. There wouldn't be an old building in the house covered outside. We'll see what happens.
Yeah. There wasn't too many other ones still pending. The one would be Denny Meyer at Hope.
Yard Arm?
His yard ornament?
Yeah.
Ted has not talked to Demi for a while. And do you just want a formal?
That's good.
Bolt upside down the trigger for the
years. Okay, then my house next block.
I think we're going to have to send him an official letter. He can come down here and tell us this.
He claims it's a guy.
No, he really didn't have
to. Seriously?
Oh, okay.
He's gonna see what he's gonna try to.
That was the answer to the somewhat tongue in cheek.
He's just gonna see.
I'd say he'd be consistent about something.
Yeah. What about the will card?
I've sent him one, asking him to get everything locked up. And he has till, I think it's Wednesday, or a week before the padlock. Open doors. Part of the deal, though, is that it's that way on purpose, because one of them is blocked open downstairs with the screen door on. He wants the ventilation.
Well, I know this. I was just sitting out front of my building the other day, and I can smell from that building the mice and the rock that's starting to come. So we are getting close to that building being in trouble. You just stand right there where that wood fence is. Just take a big whiff. You can tell that building is rock. But if you go down that basement, there's mud that thick. Not that I'm telling you.
What do you do, Ernie?
I don't know.
You have a tough time doing that. That's all correct. Asbestos, you know, you got asbestos problems.
You know, why can't we change?
Well, we can try it.
As far as that, the fence on that house, whose fence is that?
It's not mine, because it's not my property. But if he hasn't got it, it's not going to be like that with Mark on it. Yeah, I fixed it the last time, and I'm going to fix it again. Just I'm not going to put a whole lot of money in something that's really not mine.
Sure.
So it doesn't make my building look any better either.
Anything else pending on nuisances, then?
Well, for safety reasons, if there's a hand coming on, we know that they would walk into that building.
Oh, and I told him that. It's a nuisance. It's also an attractive nuisance for the youngsters.
And I'm afraid that that's why that's broken down right now. It's not there. So apparently, kids are probably already feeling it. You know, could be a nice little party spot. I don't know. It's 16 hours.
I think we ought to send one to Ed. He's not doing too good. I'm not sure. I don't know what to do about the lady with all the toys and stuff.
Mark?
Yes. I've got two calls on that.
I'm sure they're not.
They got it in the rough, right?
Yeah.
What's the suggestion? I don't want to get anybody else first. There we go.
Different issue on Iowa State Bank in the parking out in front of their facility. They have one parking space out in front of Iowa State. Oftentimes that one parking space is taken up by people. They say we're most likely patronizing the bar. But anyway, they have asked us whether they could erect a bank parking on the site.
I would say absolutely.
Jerry's
going to want one. Trevor's going to want one.
Woodward's going to want three.
Yeah, that's not going to
work. Well, all that parking on the other side.
And they would have had more parking had they not put in the drive-through, too. They kind of did that.
I tend to agree with that. That's about the only answer you can have. Other than this one, it would be a parking time limitation. Very good. This will happen just kind of an FYI. Ron from Potts Bending. He is coming to town. We will get a transient merchant permit to be able to set up his little vending trailer that sells mini donuts, that type of stuff. He would set up by stock popcorn area on July 2nd, 3rd, and 4th. And he'll be getting a transit permit. He's as much as we need to be able to do that.
What's the song?
Hot vending or something.
Ryan went back for like three orders, so.
So a satisfied customer.
Yeah, if that's who it was, I'm pretty sure that was the name.
Give me a funny shit.
actually think that they're the chair of the commission.
That's what he has, kind of, we should have, yeah.
That'll change. Also, we've got John Smith stopped down and was asking about mini golf, and do we have any rental arrangements where maybe the dance corps and the wrestling team could rent the place? So he was checking back through all the minutes about what we do allow for that, and it is that you can rent the course for one weeknight for $200. So you can expect maybe something to happen down there with the dance corps and the wrestling team.
So for their own use, or for a fundraiser, or what?
I'm not really sure on that is, but didn't ask too much about it, but I trust it would be for some sort of a fundraiser.
Is that the John Smith that had trouble with his dog?
That could be one.
You see.
The John Smith, whose son is the county attorney?
I don't care who he is. He's got a barking dog, he's got a barking dog.
My last issue is somewhat an issue for Bill also, because it... Well, Bill, because it deals with Bill Wallison, and Bill Wallison has approached us about being able to put a windmill out on his barn place. And this would be a large windmill that would be hooked into the grid. You know, we're back at that same point where we were with Daryl Meister, who talked about doing this a year or two ago. And you know, we would need to have some sort of an interconnection agreement with them before we would allow them to put this up and get connected into the grid. Okay? Before we would work on an interconnection agreement with them, we want some sort of a system impact study done to know what the impact really is to our system and to the economics of the system. You know, because the idea is if they generate some power, we end up buying power at some point. Now they think you buy it at some inflated rate, and you don't. You buy it at market, which is when that thing's generating, it's oftentimes little or nothing that we're paying for power. But we don't need the power at that time either. So what we have said is that we will require this system impact study. It needs to be done by an engineer. And Bill called me a couple days ago and said, yep, okay, that's fine. Give me a proposal from your engineer to let me know how much it's going to cost to have this study done. I've not gotten a proposal from an engineer pending our discussion tonight about your engineer medical.
That guy
was
really expensive.
Will this affect any if we get in with New America or Waffle B after us?
It depends how big it is.
So we don't want to do anything that would affect contract with them.
Does this have to be in the boots of place though, or anything like that?
It's still your handy and you have to hire your own power. Do you need that?
I don't even know really enough to tell me. Yeah, I think we got to buy some power, but I don't know.
That market price.
Yeah, I don't know if we need to let them do this.
I would just say yes.
Yeah, that's the first question. Are we required to let them do this? And if the answer is no, we're not required. We may very well want to send out.
Kurt said the avoided cost.
Kurt said what?
You can't add cost to the other customers to reduce this cost.
Because the one thing he came in and specifically asked for, or this guy who's trying to sell the windmill came in and specifically asked for, we want to bank demand charges. We want to be able to offset our highest demand time when we're using the most power with the highest demand time of when the generator's producing the most. And of course, they're never the same time. So it does us no good to do that.
But has to be somebody we can go to and say, what are our requirements? What do we have to do?
Are we mandated by law if they want to do that? Okay. Where would we go to find that?
Yeah, we can talk with IAMU would be a first call to know for sure.
I'd say we do that. Because I'm all in favor of it. If we can say no, then we say no.
Yes.
It means nothing. If we can't say no, then we say yes the hardest way we can. I'm serious. That's what... When that guy called me, that's what I told him. We're going to make you jump through every hoop we can possibly make you jump through, to be honest with you, because we don't want you.
It not good for the system.
He told me the only way he could make that work was by reducing his demand. And there's no way we would ever do that. That's why I can't see where he would come back with even another proposal.
Well, I believe there's an $80,000 government grant involved in this.
I'm sure there's money somehow.
Yeah.
This ain't a guy that's really good for the environment. Is he? He's just a
bunch of power. Luck.
Green power?
Yeah. I know it is. We're opening up can of worms here.
Well, I think the first thing we do is we get that, get an opinion from them, what they think we can legally say. We take it from there.
I bet our city attorney can figure that out.
I'll be on the phone with Scott. Because I am here.
Okay.
But that gentleman just got sued. Public knowledge. It was in the Carroll paper.
But I don't know if that really would make any difference. If this was somebody else, it'd be the same thing.
Yeah.
If it was John Westergaard wanting to put up with, I think we'd all be the same way.
I would hope to show.
But
I'm so scary.
I guess that's just the wrong way off. Give me a week and I'll take that over.
Okay, we're down to the council room.
Yep, really, that's it. Next meeting would be on Tuesday, July 5th. Vaughn?
Can we, I'd like to go back to the public forum deal if I could. Over the years, I've worked for the city now almost 27 years, and we had a lot of people involved in this deal that we did. And no one would have known about it if we wouldn't have went out and got the word out, you know. And something that I've heard other councilmen say, and maybe you guys have said it too, after something's passed, then people start complaining about it. And then they say, well, why weren't you at the meeting? Well, when this stuff comes in the paper, and maybe it's something that Aaron or Marcia could be doing, but it'll say we're voting on resolution 112. And it doesn't say what it's about in the paper. And I'd like to have it say, you know, what that issue is in the paper, not just resolution 112. I've talked to you about this before, Scott, you know, because if you want people to get involved, they need to know, and the only way they know is by going to the paper. And, I mean, is it something that the council has to say that they want Marcia to put it in the paper, or does Marcia just do it if we ask her? I mean,
we just for the stories or the minutes.
Well, when you read the council minutes in the paper, it'll say, okay, they voted on resolution 1112. Nobody knows what it is. Well, then it's voted on. Then the people find out what it is, and then they're upset. And I just think you could get through a lot less.
We have to post like so far in advance, like the P&Z.
Well, I'm not just talking about zoning either. I'm talking about a lot of resolutions that get passed. Could they be printed out in the paper? I mean, or is that an expense to the city?
Yeah, it's extra expense when you do that.
But is that, I mean, it can't cost that much more. I mean,
we don't tell her what to print either.
Well, but this is, if you do, that's why it'd be expense to the city, you know.
Yeah.
But I guess I was a little upset on how things went around. You know, you're hearing, well, Lon's out there getting petitions. Andy even brought it up. Well, you know, we had everybody's signature in just that area. Andy couldn't have got any signatures down there unless he went to you, Brian, which he works for the city too, and he didn't want to get involved, and Emily Onstein. Almost everybody else down there signed. Well, you know, Andy was upset because, well, I could have went out and got signatures too. Well, not down there he couldn't have. I mean, that's how many people were upset about this deal, and it wasn't the fact that I just went out and got signatures. They showed up for the meetings too, you know. And
why didn't you sign? Because I can't vote.
Well, you know, but I went and talked to you.
Oh, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
I went and talked to everybody down there.
Yeah.
But I don't know
how you get notice out to everybody, because,
well, if it's in the paper though, Aaron, I think, you know, that would help. To a certain extent.
But it still all happens after the fact, though, Lon. I mean,
well, that's what I mean. It should have happened after the fact. It should be posted before that. I, you know, maybe maybe that it can't be done that way.
It'd be difficult because of the way timing oftentimes works out, especially with a weekly newspaper. You can't put that stuff out that far in advance.
What would be so difficult about saying proposal umpty-dump concern such and such? I mean, you wouldn't have to go into any depth about it, but at least it would give the public an idea of what that particular proposal is in general. And if they're interested, they could show up and find out about it.
Well, we've never thought about it because we just have done what everybody's done in the past.
Well, and you know, and I know that, and I've worked, like I say, I've worked here 27 years, and that's the way it's always been done. And I mean, Scott and I have talked about this for years. I brought this up to him because it always kind of upset me. It's like, it, not that you're trying to hide something, but that's what the public perception is that you're trying to hide it and just run it through, you know?
So what would happen if we put it on the website?
Well, maybe that would be all right.
It's just a tentative agenda that they're looking for, really, because that tells you
such
regarding whatever it is.
Yeah. Do you have something that you thought would...
I didn't know if you guys published this in the paper or not, but this is pretty informative. If this got out beforehand.
This isn't even cut and dry until like Thursday.
I'm aware of that. I'm talking about as a tentative agenda.
Website, that would be...
Yeah, website would be...
And, you know, a lot of the times you have your first reading, but it could still be posted that you have to do a second and a third reading on a lot of those things. So if it was maybe, I like the website idea. I'm not big on computers, but I mean, it's a good idea. I mean, and that wouldn't cost the city anything to do that.
I think that's about the only way it's going to get out there.
That's get out there in a timely fashion.
Yeah. We can try that and see if it...
And maybe it's just
board out here and everything.
You know, at least you guys could come back and say, you know, well, hey, we even had this on the website, you know, just you know, to make the public more aware of stuff that's going on.
They're not hiding nothing, so public.
Well, you know, but I don't. Andy was very upset, and that wasn't our intention, guys. I mean. But then again, it concerned everybody down there. It was voted down 5-0 by the zoning board. And I don't know what your... I talked to a couple of the councilmen, and I don't know what their perception were. They weren't going to tell me how they were going to vote. It doesn't matter.
But he had the right to do the appeal. And that's why he did it. He had the right to do that. And we're obligated to listen to it.
Well, and then the zoning board told us that you guys could overturn it. I don't necessarily know if that's the right thing to do, but... Especially if you got a zoning board that's there to protect the citizens' rights, so are you guys. But
like on that zoning thing, you had to send a letter to all the people that were around it.
Well, 200 feet. Just 200 feet.
It's defined within our code as far as who needs to receive the notice.
And then it would have been up to all them people to get it out, which that's what happened. And the reason I really found out about it before that, because Steve Shotten told me. He's, you know, he called me up, said, get your butt down to the bank. I'll talk to you. And what do I do now, you know? And but then he told me about it, you know, so.
Banking problems.
Yeah, I always got banking problems.
That's usually telling me, hey, put your money somewhere.
But, you know, I like Whitey's idea of putting it on the internet. At least it's out there for the public to see.
Well, we can certainly try to put a format together that this is what's going to be coming up and what is going to happen.
You know,
Curtis, you always post it via Twitter and such, you know, in advance too. I mean, if people were just educated that there's other means outside of just our site too. I mean, that's much more, you know, proactive, I guess, because somebody's going to have to go.
Can we stick one of these up at the post office?
Can we?
Everybody goes to the post office. Just
well, and could it be that when you put your minutes in the paper or posting something on it in the council, have Marcia just say, you know, there's more information available on the internet at this website if you're interested, you know?
But I don't know if there's going to necessarily be more information. I mean, we post the agenda.
I've read it a lot of times, you know, they pass zoning issue. You know, let's just say 11-12. Nobody even knows what it is.
Well, but if they go to the back page and read the actual meeting, it's on there.
If on the Monday before the zoning board makes a recommendation, it won't come out in the paper till the following Wednesday. Well, the Monday before that Wednesday, we've already had a council meeting.
But that was the first reading. You have to have three readings on a lot of these, I guess what I'm saying, on resolutions, don't you?
Only on ordinances.
Okay. There's more rules on than the most of us.
Well, and that's why I'm asking if there's a different way we can get the public
probably
to understand or more informed, I guess.
Well, we can certainly try to put it on the webpage so people know what's coming up.
Mm-hmm. Is your new sign capable of carrying enough detail to tell the public when something that you feel is contentious might be coming up? I mean, because you know what the discussion is going to be about if there's going to be something.
That's not what that sign is. There was other organizations that paid for part of that sign.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's kind of a feel-good sign.
Yeah.
Okay.
We don't want that.
Gotcha.
Right?
I think the internet. Yeah,
it sounds like a good idea. We can give the world. And then we just let Marcia know that we're doing that. And I'm sure it'll make an ad in the paper. Somewhere in the paper it'll get mentioned. Mm-hmm.
Because everybody does that anymore.
Yeah,
but it's kind of the same thing. We post an agenda on the website, and that gets posted on Friday, and we meet on Monday. I mean, it's still not a lot of time.
If they want. And if there's a resolution, we can try to put on there what it's about.
That's what I'd like to see. So it kind of goes into detail you could on the internet with it. I mean, necessarily doesn't have to be in the paper, I guess, but you know. It sure isn't going to hurt.
But everybody's entitled to come down here and put their views to the council. That's what everybody's done.
Yeah.
And then that's what it's all about.
Well, I mean, I thought this worked out good. Maybe not for Andy, but I don't think Andy would have pursued it if he knew it was against the law either.
I don't think he would have either.
You know, I think Andy was uninformed.
He felt that it shouldn't have got this far. Had he known that, he wouldn't have done that.
Well, I think that could be true. But, you know, he did contact the lawyer, and I mean, we did. I mean, because it all got started. We got on the internet and looked. Lynn Dunn did, and he brought me this piece of paper saying, here's a case right here, you know. And
he was certainly within his rights to, once the P&Z rejected him, he was entitled to come to the council and ask.
Yeah, sure.
But we were obligated to listen to everybody.
Yeah. I mean, if it wouldn't have got that far, I mean, there wouldn't have been as many hard feelings. I'm sure about that.
Right. But every time we get a hard feeling like that, there's always hard feelings. Never seen one didn't. Sometimes against the wrong people. Yep. One more thing.
The city administrator makes a very web-friendly PDF documents out of his council packets. He's capable of that. Has the skills. That stuff would be very easy to post on the internet. You're talking about getting more detail of the resolution. You could post the entire proposed resolution with a little thing at the bottom saying this is only proposed, this may change, on the website.
Well, we didn't give him a very big raise to make it worse.
Yeah. What's that?
Yeah, bigger one than I got.
I'm just saying on the internet there's no space limitations. You can just do that.
Well, I have every confidence that when Scott puts this on the page, it'll be what, and if it isn't, we'll look at it.
And then can we tell Aaron to say that, you know, when she puts them in there, city minutes say that on the bottom, more information available on the city website.
We would certainly like more input from the public than we normally get, which is usually nothing until it's over and done with.
Well, that's just it.
And then they woke up and...
If you would just put something like this on there, just like it is.
We'll give it a whirl.
Just like that.
Well, you could post the whole packet.
Yeah, but I mean,
I'm just saying.
This will be all the talking points that we're going to have. So if there's something that would interest you as an individual, then you could come and see or listen or speak to people. If you put all this in there, then they won't read it anyway.
No.
I mean, you want to find out what's important to me. I don't really care if he gets his liquor license or that. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I can look at it, but...
You love the first time you come in here and I don't have no beer.
Yeah. You don't care then.
Well, let's start off with the agenda and kind of go at it.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens. That's a good start. I mean, that's an easy fix. That's what I have.
Thanks.
Bill.
John and Scott and the whole council, when Bill Walson comes and wants a report done, what we need from him is his plans and his specifications of what he proposes to put on our system. And that's what we bring for our engineer. You just can't say, I'm going to put a windmill on your system. I, In fact, he needs to give you the plans and specifications.
Let's get a legal opinion first, and I agree with you 100%, because like I said, it puts more than just him, it puts all of us.
It affects the whole utility.
Exactly. Yeah. It's not just...
And it's a big safety issue.
There you go.
We don't want that generator anymore out working on a line.
There you go.
That's
to be... It's a pretty simple answer, as far as I'm concerned, but let somebody tell me different. You want to use that so bad, don't you?
I tell you, I'm just practicing.
Yeah.
Anybody got anything else? Both of you adjourned. Second? Means adjourned.
I'm second.
Somebody did.